February 28th, and Scott and I have been talking of 2009, and Scott and I have been having a time in the Word and in prayer, and some serious discussions about a choice we have to make, tracheostomy or not. And we have been prayerfully seriously considering this since the 3rd of February when we went to Dr. Bendit, the pulmonologist. And again, he emphasized to us, as he did in January of 2008, over a year ago, that we need to move on this trach if we're going to elect to do it. And last April, I have footage of the time where we went through where Scott was going to have the tracheostomy, trach surgery, and God switched that around and he didn't need it. We had this appointment set up for a Tuesday, and things changed for Scott on the Saturday before. We did, however, follow up with Dr. Brodie, the surgeon, and he said, well, you have your voice, and let's maintain your voice as long as you can. And so that was last April, and here it is February, and we met Dr. Brodie this last Monday, and again picked up the conversation we had as we had with him last April. So we're still kind of have been waiting, and we decided not to decide, but then we're also thinking we need to decide in case it became an emergent kind of situation. We have to know what we're persuaded in. So Scott and I have been talking again. We've spent hours and hours and hours talking about the many, many rational things and irrational things and spiritual priorities, and we've just looked up at this one way, upside down, and the other way. So anyway, I'm going to let Scott speak for himself and share some of his thoughts of what God's been speaking this morning. Okay? Hello.
Hello. Hi.
Hey, you're looking pretty good.
Wow.
So this last Monday when he asked you, was it worth it not having done this trach last April? At the New Horizon Christian Academy, we went there last October, and we met many of these boys and more in Flagstaff. We went because of Pastor Daniel and because of Nick's death, and Nick is right there. But just the influence, we just really felt compelled to go, and we were, by the grace of God, able to make that trip. We took all seven of our family members, and Corbin wasn't born yet, but now there's a total of eight in our family. But so you were thinking of that question, was it worth it?
I thought, of course, it was worth it. Have the opportunity to share our testimony with the boys, and how I believe God has a future with them. Amen.
We believe strongly that God has a future involving that work?
What else?
What else? Well, what's God been, what happened when I was praying and what God impressed on you after we've just been fellowshipping for the last few hours? What's God been speaking to you today?
My wife was folded, closed, and prayer. I heard very clearly a still, small voice say to me, "Will you follow me even if you are healed?"
Even if you aren't healed.
Listen to me, say, "Yes, Lord."
Here, let me take care of that for you. Okay.
And then I protect you from the devil. Amen. And you said, "What about dying? What about pneumonia? What? Fear. Fear.
Fear gripped you."
And then I thought of Peter. She said, "I said, why you follow me also?" And Peter said, "Who else has the words of the life?"
So God had asked you, will you follow me even if you don't get your healing? And you said,
yes.
And then immediately the devil projected a thought of, "What if you die? What about the pneumonia? What about the breath?" And you thought of this, the account of Peter walking on the water. Oh, sorry. Peter saying, "You have the words of life. Where else will I go?"
And then a priest offered me, "Because, so what if I die? My spirit will live forever with the Lord." But I've learned I will be healed. Amen.
Amen. And why do you believe that so strongly?
Because I had a vision in Arizona 11 years ago.
Your vision has just sustained you. You just hold to that as an anchor. Your encounter with Christ.
And that is on my web page.
That's on your, you've written that down on your web page. And then that's been confirmed by just that same thought, that this disease is not unto death, but for the glory of God, has been confirmed by, well, at least two times by different people in different years. Very, significantly given that word for Scott. And just two nights ago you got a word from a dear friend of faith who felt inspired to write quite a bit down and share with you an encouragement in the Lord about a healing, and just numerous other times under teaching and hearing of the word. Okay, you want us? We want to show you. This is just a little memorials to Scott's little his account, his story right there written. And there's us during that time in 1998. And Death Valley, we went there in 2000. And just some cactus. And then there's a note from the Christian Academy, the staff there, we got a couple days ago. That was very encouraging. From the Flags in Flagstaff, Arizona, sent that. So we just have these reminders of future purpose and hope that God's given. We just celebrated Scott's 50th birthday just 8 days ago. We had a open house kind of birthday party, went on for 6 hours, had, I don't know, 55 people plus so many more responding on emails and cards sent, and just really feel loved and blessed.
Amen.
Amen. Anything else you'd like to sign off with?
Praise the Lord. His word worthy to be praised. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.